The US government made a really strange proclamation recently. The Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA, officially advised people not to inject themselves with blood plasma from young people. Our colleague Angela covered this story, and we asked her for a dramatic reading.
Yeah, so this is the bulletin from the FDA notice, and they said, "The reported uses of these products should not be assumed to be safe or effective. We strongly discourage consumers from pursuing this therapy."
This begs the question, why on earth did the FDA need to say such a thing? Who was giving out rogue transfusions of young blood? The answer is bizarre. It involves a real scientific study that gets distorted and misapplied, some credulous news outlets and sketchy entrepreneurs, and a few people going to dramatic lengths to stay young. The big medical idea here is that maybe something inside a young, healthy person could help an older person get healthier. Historically, people have tested that idea with a creepy procedure called parabiosis.
So parabiosis is basically taking two animals, cutting them up, and sewing them together.
The technique goes all the way back to 1864, but it got popular with medical researchers starting in the 1950s. The hope was that if you stitched together the circulatory systems of two mice, for example, you could see whether the blood of one affected the other.
And specifically then, they were interested in seeing if one animal, the older animal, could live longer if it was attached to the younger animal.
Those experiments set the stage, but the modern obsession with young blood owes a lot to a study from 2005. The lead authors were Michael and Arena Comboy, a husband and wife team at UC Berkeley. Using parabiosis, they attached an old mouse and a young mouse together to see what would happen to specific body systems, their muscles, their livers, their brains, and they found that some of the tissues in the older mouse got younger.
It was the first study to show that aging of tissues could be very rapidly reset back, and we could observe young tissues in an animal that is analogous to 75-year-old person.
It was a hell of a finding, and the news ricocheted all over the place.
Oh no, it was immediate interest and hype.
Yeah, we got our full 15 minutes of fame back then.
Yeah.
And then there was a lot of excitement from, you know, the non-scientific field and lay people, because we all want to live longer and be healthy, and so it just seemed like a very promising and interesting potential treatment.
How far would you go to look and feel younger?
Scientists may have found a real fountain of youth, one that can repair aging.
But the actual findings were more complicated. First, while the old mouse seemed to improve, at the same time, the young mouse suffered. Its muscle and liver and brain health deteriorated. That finding received a lot less hype.
So there are two equally important observations, but everybody just jumped on the bandwagon of rejuvenation.
And second, there was the possibility that blood wasn't the full story. Grafting two mice together meant that they were influenced by each other's organs, too.
Old mice benefited from young heart, young lungs, young kidney, and young liver. So it was not just the blood exchange. It was as if you had a backpack with young organs which work on your behalf.
But neither complication stopped this young blood idea from taking off like wildfire.
So in everybody's mind, it was the cure against aging. And it was a relatively easy way to get your paper published in a high-impact journal or to get research funding, because there was so much interest in that.
It was the password to get published in Science.
Exactly.
It was literally
password to get your paper at least reviewed.
Since 2005, there's been a lot more research into parabiosis in young blood. Lots more studies bolstered the ideas found in the Comboy's work. Others complicated them. A few went looking for specific proteins that might play a role. The Comboys worked on their follow-up in 2016 that used transfusions rather than parabiosis, and it suggested that old blood hurts more than young blood helps. All in all, the science marched along.
Nowadays, you know, the aging research field is doing well, and I think that there's a consensus that, you know, there's something in the blood that helps regulate aging.
So how do we get from here to the FDA's warning? Well, as careful as the scientific community was, there was still the hype, the fountain of youth idea. And all of that hype created a crack in the hard science.
There is this dead zone between scientific discussion and popularized hype about the science.
Into that dead zone stepped entrepreneur Jesse Carmazin. In 2016, he was a recent med school graduate who was reportedly so inspired by parabiosis research that he founded his own health startup, Ambrosia.
We're a company interested in making you young again.
He wasn't alone. Other companies have popped up to search for blood proteins that regulate aging and base new drugs on them. Ambrosia took a different tack.
It took these mice studies and said, we can turn this into a treatment for humans, and if you give us $8,000, we'll give you some young blood transfusions, and it'll, you know, reverse aging and cure all your other ills.
Ambrosia technically performed a human trial, offering patients a liter or two of human plasma from an under 25 donor, but they charged their test subjects, didn't publish their results, and didn't even include a control group. The company was always light on the details, which for the convoys was the scariest part.
If it doesn't work, we need to know about it, right? And if people are having side effects, we need to know about it. If it does work, of course, we need to know about that too. But you can't just be hyping something and promising something and say, look, it works great. All these people are so much healthier, because people try to fool people all the time, right?
The whole thing was sketchy at best. But again, it made for a great story.
Listen to this. A startup claims to have found the fountain of youth, and it is young blood.
If true, this is huge, right?
It got wild. There were rumors that tech investor Peter Thiel was super interested in young blood and in Ambrosia. The idea even got lampooned in an episode of Silicon Valley.
Are you really not familiar with parabiosis?
Can't say that I am.
Well, the science is actually pretty fascinating.
The hype can have only helped Karmazin's notoriety, and he was reportedly this close to opening up clinics in the US when the FDA brought the hammer down. Ambrosia ceased operations, and today their website is basically empty, apart from some stock video of greenery waving in the breeze. By the way, we tried to get a hold of Jesse Karmazin for comment, but we never heard back. So that's the story. Ultimately, it was a pretty small blip in the world of medical business. Karmazin told Bloomberg that he only treated about 150 patients total, but even those few subjects may have been at risk. Blood transfusions are commonly used in life-threatening situations, but as an elective procedure, it makes less sense. Pumping someone else's blood into your body puts you at risk of allergic reactions, infections, and even a rare lung injury.
I don't know about everybody else out there, but for me, that risk would, you know, far outweigh any potential benefits I'd get in the short term for getting that blood product.
The lab experiments worked in part because inbred mice were used, so their bodies were extremely compatible. Not so for humans.
It's like you have identical twins, but one twin is 75 and another twin is 20 years old. So that's what we can do in a laboratory. For people, we are not genetically matched.
Which points to maybe the biggest lesson here. It's a lesson that Ambrosia didn't learn, which earned them the scorn of scientists and ultimately cost them a lot.
Ambrosia took these promising studies that were in mice and made this huge leap and tried to apply them to humans and take a lot of money for it. You know, humans are not mice, obviously, and what works for them might not work for us. And yet it was still trying to take money and kind of, I think, prey on people's desire to fix their illness or feel young.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. We obviously try not to give medical advice ourselves, so if you're still curious about this kind of therapy, here are the convoys talking about it one last time.
So that's, again, a warning to people, just do not do weird stuff and inject yourself with somebody else's body fluids. You don't even know what is being put into you.